There's something about plants that make me really happy. It feels like you brought a little piece of nature into your home. It just lightens your space up and brightens it. And when you see a plant thrive, which you have given your loving care and your precious time, it is such a rewarding feeling. So in today's video, I will tell you about my personal favorite 10 indoor plants, which are really easy to care and grows really well into an Indian plant. So without any delay, let's get started with the video.
So the first plant on my list is Syngonium. It's a great looking elegant houseplant which needs only modest care. Its attractive colored foliage will add up the beauty in your house and have the ability to cleanse the air you breathe. Now I will tell about its watering. Syngonium likes moist soil during its growing period. Otherwise, watering twice in a week should be enough during summer. But allow the plant dry out slightly between watering, because no plant likes soggy soil. Or you can clean the leaves to free them from dust accumulation. And Syngonium needs bright light but not direct sunlight. The next plant is rubber plant. So this is the Indian rubber plant, which is most commonly available in India. The best thing about them is this dark burgundy color that they have. Coming to the watering, you should keep the soil moist but not drowning. You should also wipe the leaves down with a damp cloth to keep them moist and to help your plant absorb more sunlight. Rubber plants like bright light and lot of it, but not direct sunlight. If you are looking for adding some height in your spot, I think rubber plants are great. The next plant on my list is China palm or Chinese fan palm. And it is a big plant with sprawling fan-like fronds that grows up to 2 feet across. And China palm likes bright light, but getting too much sunlight, it can burn the leaves. It can tolerate medium light, but avoid low light situations as its growth will slow. And water your fan palm thoroughly, then allow the soil to dry slightly between waterings. I think watering on alternative days will be okay. The next plant on my list is Croton, and I love this plant so much because of its colorful foliage. In India, there are many varieties of Crotons are available. I have two of them. This plant requires bright light to produce gorgeous yellow, red and purple foliage. If the plant is lacking the light, it requires the leaves will turn green. And if you see the leaves starting to droop, check the soil and water. Look at this curling foliage. And here the another one which I have. If you like to add some color in your house, I think Croton is the best option. The next on the list is Adelia. And Adelia comes in different varieties such as variegated white Adelia, variegated Adelia, ball Adelia, and many more. So for Adelia, regular water is needed, especially during hot, dry weather. However, the soil should dry out between waterings. And Adelia also likes bright light, so you should place it beside a window. So the next plant on my list is Wandering Jew. I like it because of its colorful long vines, and it requires very minimal care. It also needs moist soil and a space that has bright light. If the light is too dim, the leaf markings will fade. You can propagate it from its vines. Simply place a cutting into moist soil and it will survive. The next plant is Dracaena, and it's popularly known as Song of India. And Dracaena is an excellent house plant because it's very hardy. I mean, even though you forget to water it, it can survive. This plant needs indirect light and warm temperatures. They prefer humidity, so you can mist your plant regularly. If the leaves are turning yellow, it's most likely too dry. And you can also propagate it from its cuttings. So the next plant on my list is spider plant. And the spider plant is among the most popular and easiest to grow of all hanging or trailing house plants. Spider plants prefer moist soil, so you should water them liberally through the summer and mist them occasionally. And they are prone to tip burn, which can be caused by dry soil, low humidity. So keep the soil slightly moist and cut off the brown tips if they do occur. So the next one is Purple Heart, and it is a perennial native to North America and can be grown in full sun to partial shade. And it produces small pale pink flowers from the tips of the stem and last only one day. Water the Purple Heart twice in a week. Allow the soil to dry out on the surface between waterings to keep the roots healthy. You can propagate Purple Heart from its cuttings, but whenever you cut the vine, be careful about its tanning because it could cause irritation on your skin if come in contact. The next plant on my list is money plant, and it is also known as devil's ivy. I believe money plant is the most popular house plant among all, and it is the best plant to grow indoor as well as outdoor. It has large, glossy, heart-shaped leaves. It is easy to grow, look excellent, and is also efficient at removing indoor pollutants. They have many varieties. Look, this one has comparatively bigger leaves. And you can propagate it through its cuttings. You can grow it in water also. And coming to its watering, water twice a week is sufficient. It thrives in both full sun and partial shade. Plants are inseparable part of our lives. So bring them into your lives and they will make your life and home more beautiful. So that's all for today's video. If you have any queries and suggestions regarding this video, please feel free to comment. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video. Bye.